Seriously? Again?
I've got HPV. I've got so many strains in me. It all started with an abnormal pap smear at my Lilly. The gyno said HPV is the most common STD.
Wait, I haven't had sex in months, and I used a condom.
What does it all mean?
Don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel.
HPV.
Are you ready for some good questions?
Yeah, let's do it.
What does HPV stand for?
I don't
know. Human
papillomavirus.
I know the V's a virus.
Humanopapillovirus?
Human papillomavirus?
Yes!
Okay.
Papilloma!
Did I say that right?
Papilloma.
Yes!
We are talking about HPV with Dr. Lilly Hanna today. I have tons of questions about it. Because you know what? Getting HPV, it's as easy as 1, 2, 3. Everybody has it. Everybody I know has it. It's so common. What is going on with that?
You are correct.
Well, let's just start with the simple thing. What do the H and the P and the V stand for?
HPV stands for human papillomavirus.
Oh. So HPV is a virus that is spread through
skin-to-skin
contact.
Yes.
Now, it is also a sexually transmitted disease, because when you're having sex, you are touching skin.
Correct.
Does that mean, even if someone is wearing a condom, you could pass it along?
Yes.
You can pass it along?
Yes.
Okay.
So condoms still are somewhat effective, just not 100% like they are for other diseases that are born through fluid. So semen, vaginal fluid, those are the things that are protected with dental dams and condoms. The skin-to-skin contact is only, you just decrease your risk. It's not completely removed.
80% of women have HPV, true or false?
You said 80%?
Yep.
80%? False.
True?
True.
I'm gonna say yes.
You got it, girl. I mean, not that you got it, but yes, that is correct. Men get HPV, true or false?
True.
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 It's true. You giveth, but you don't taketh away. How many strains of HPV are there?
At least 10.
Two.
100.
Really?
Yes!
Over 100.
There's tons of HPV. I have half of those right now.
What are the symptoms of HPV?
There are none.
There are no symptoms.
No.
So how do you find out if you have HPV?
So HPV is tested through the pap smear.
Okay.
And specifically HPV testing with the pap smear. So if a pap is normal, that means that the cells on your cervix and vagina are normal.
Okay.
And they don't have any disease or any changes with those cells. However, there is testing that goes along with the pap smear for particular populations in terms of their age populations, that get tested automatically for HPV, presence or absence.
Okay.
So a woman younger than 30 who is getting her pap smear routinely will just get a pap smear to check for the cells of the cervix and to see if there's disease there, but is not routinely tested for HPV unless there is a problem with the cells.
Oh, interesting.
Right.
But then after...
But after age 30, everybody gets tested for HPV.
Well, why is that?
The cervical tissue isn't turning over as much as when you were in your 20s and your teens. So as a result, when HPV shows up, it lingers longer. And the longer HPV sticks around, the greater the risk of disease.
What can, at worst case scenario, HPV lead to?
Cervical cancer. It's actually also vaginal cancer and vulvar cancer and anal cancer. So a lot of the external genitalia can have exposure to HPV and develop cancer that way. However, once these things happen, should they ever, it's not said and done. So surgical procedures to remove the diseased tissue is still very much an option. Radiation et cetera. So it just depends on the cancer. Smoking can actually worsen the response of HPV with your body. So the HPV has a greater opportunity to do its damage, if you will, in smokers.
Name three places you can get HPV. And I'm not talking about like an airport bathroom.
Your holes.
The orifices.
Your jennies.
Your jennies.
Gina?
Yep, yep. Can you also get it in your eye?
The brain?
Not unless you're having sex with it.
Your hole.
Butthole?
Butthole.
And the mouth.
And the old moutharoo. Do you know what cancer it causes?
Cervical?
Cervical. Cervical cancer.
Boom.
Boom. Okay, you've been cervicaled.
So what do you do if you have it? What does the doctor do?
It's so common that younger women under the age of 21 have stopped getting evaluations for pap smears because at their sexual debut, a lot of women will have HPV and then the body will naturally clear it. It's like the common cold of the vagina.
Okay, you just have a cold.
That's it.
Achoo!
Ooh, God bless you.
Your vagina sneezed. It's just coughing. It'll stop.
That's right.
Is there a cure for it?
There's not a cure.
Okay.
No.
There is a vaccine for it.
That's right.
When would you get the vaccine? Let's start with that.
The age range now, the recommendation is 11 to 12 years old.
And is there an age where you just don't bother getting it?
There used to be a cutoff of the age of 25 to 26, but the recommendations have actually expanded recently to up to age 45.
Oh.
Right. Now, it's a conversation to be had between the doctor and patient. Mm-hmm.
There are also so many strains of it. It's like LaCroix. You can get all kinds.
Yes. So some of them are cancerous and some of them are not.
Oh.
Fortunately, most of them are not.
Most of them are not cancerous.
That's right.
So it's easy to take care of.
Absolutely.
And because we're regularly getting checked, we catch it early and we get it done.
Yes.
So that's why you have to keep getting it checked.
That's right. With the guidance of your physician and how frequently you need to go.
Okay. Thank you so much for coming. You answered my questions.
Well, thank you for having me.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, there you have it. HPV is the most common STD you probably have right now. Kidding. We're all in this together. And don't worry. If you have it, there's ways to treat it. And if you don't have it and you're considering the vaccine, talk to your doctor about the pros and cons. Some states are making the HPV vaccination mandatory for school entry, so talk to your pediatrician. And if you like this video, make sure to like it, comment, and share. And don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel. I'm Madge the Vag, and I'm here to help. HPV and me! And you.